Burrito's owner, Shane Evans. Welcome, Shane.
Thank you.
We are very pleased to have Neato Burrito here. We've driven a lot of traffic to the West Shore Plaza in the early stages. We're very excited about, and there's been quite a buzz about Neato Burrito. Can you tell us a little bit about the history of Neato Burrito and how you started and where?
Yeah, we started in the mid-90s, 94, 95, in 3rd Street, Harrison, in a 300-square-foot space, which, put into some type of perspective, the hallway here, was bigger than our original shop, so it was very tiny. Somehow managed to do the whole build-out ourselves. Plumbing, electrical, my dad built the cabinets. It was very shoestring, very low budget. And from there came Illinois across the street. That was 1997 that we opened the second location. And from there we went to Cumberland and bought the old firehouse. That was the last incarnation of a brew pub. And that was 2000 that we did that, opened there. And since then, opened at the Scottsdale Plaza, Windsor Park, Mechanicsburg. Just the newest market for us. First time out of the Harrisburg market. We now live in Lancaster. The same time we opened the shop, and now here.
Okay. So how many total?
Six.
One of the things that we've noticed since we've gotten a relationship with you is social media prowess, particularly with Facebook, and the large number of followers and fans that you have. How do you see Facebook as playing a role in your business? How do you use it to improve your business?
We find it to be kind of an ongoing opinion poll every day. You can get feedback from the way if people think you're doing a decent job, if they think you can improve on something. It's an open forum, two-way communication. It's allowed us to, get an idea of what people really like about Neato Burrito. You can't buy it. It's just they like you and they want to be a part of it, or they don't. So we try to be pretty genuine about it, not too, not trying to sell anything in particular. Just kind of, have a little humor mixed in.
Sure. You have quite an enthusiastic following, both on Facebook and just in general.
Yeah.
What do you attribute that to?
I'd like to think, that we have good burritos to start with. That our shops are a little more eclectic. The design elements are a little, people remember them and they're a little more engaging, maybe. The staff, we try to maintain people that seem to like working here and can roll a decent burrito and interact with people and do a good job. So I think
it's great. You have a great following.
Yeah.
The West Shore Plaza, as you know, has been here for a long time, since the 1950s, 54, 55. What made you decide to come to the West Shore Plaza, or to consider the West Shore Plaza as a possible location for school?
Lemoyne's been great overall for us since we opened across the street. I think we talked a couple years before we actually did come here, and we had some interest in coming here. It's we didn't know at the time just how kind you guys are as far as going an extra mile as landlords. We've had good and bad over the years, and you guys definitely fall way onto the good side of it. Very, kind of, you kind of get that it's a two-way street, and you guys have already gone the extra mile for us a couple times with some, we weren't quite open when we wanted to be. Typically a landlord, you write a contract, you have this much time to build out, and you guys said, we'll wait to start charging your rent until you get open, which is unheard of.
Makes sense.
Yeah, so, we've just been thrilled to be here so far, and as far as, you know, why we came, it's a great space. You guys maintain them all. You have a really positive approach. You're always trying new things to keep people coming, and it's a busy, well-run mall.
Good. Well, I'm happy.
Thank you.
Thanks.